teachers, and my fellow classmates, good afternoon. The title of my speech is Values Are Values. I belong to this generation referred to as different. All of us contestants belong to this age wherein we are testament, outspoken, more daring, and more competitive. Why do you think we are the way we are? Obviously, we are born to a different world. We don't count our friends according to how many friends we have in school and how many we play with when we get home. Instead, we keep track of how many people we invite and confirm on Facebook, and how many we follow and follow us on Twitter. Gone are the days when we bathe in the rain and play with actual toys and actual physical games. We thrive on virtual personalities on the net. We tend virtual farms and harvest virtual plants. We get to know virtual neighbors, but fail to say hi to those next door. We could stay indoors for the whole day, facing the computer. Now our tools of communication are yes, no, and okay. Technology gets the better of us, from cell phones and laptops to notebooks and iPads. Even at toys and tablets. This sends us all to dizzying spiral ride, to technological blitz. The roller coaster ride in this high-tech world makes the lifestyle 10 years ago pushed into the deepest recesses of the Stone Age. Ladies and gentlemen, this is what I see. We may have been born into this crazy and noisy world where clutter is abundant and silence is scarce. But we are not at fault. We did not choose to live and to be born in this age. We are just molded to accept this set of beliefs the society has brought to our senses. It is not our fault that we opened our eyes to a different set of values. But do values change? I think not. Values are values. These are ideals and beliefs that determine our being. It is the very thread that defines our relationship with God, our relationship with our family, with our country, with ourselves, and with all of creation. These are values that will never, ever change. 100 posts on Facebook about God's message of love will never compensate for the 1 hour that we say the Mass on Sundays. Texting "I love you" to an important person will never make up for an actual hug and kiss and tears in the eyes. Sending a personal message to your friends in pain means no measure compared to the silent hold of the hand, bursting with unspoken words of comfort and love in moments of deep pain. Nothing compares to having someone by your side, and not some blinking hearts or animated smileys sent by Smiley Central. Values are values. They never change. But of course, social networking sites don't make us bad people. The internet is not the dwelling of the devil. It is there to make life easier for us. It is the pleasures of an actual human relationship that meets us real people. Face to face. Heart to heart. Soul to soul. I advocate the rediscovering and resurfacing of the values that makes us true Filipinos. The advocacy of respect. The advocacy of love. I believe the keyword would be involvement. We get involved. We get ourselves into the action. One beautiful Filipino value is the bayanihan. It is the beautiful act of helping those who need our help. With this, we reach out. We get to relate with real people. Another is the sense of utang na loob. Gratitude is a powerful deed. The fact that we do not forget an act of kindness will eventually lead us to return the deed. Gratitude will become more powerful when we pay it forward. Another exceptional value is hospitality. It is the beautiful act of warmth and welcome. This particular value sets us above all the other cultures in the world. We will give what little we have in order to afford the best to people who come into our home. Another extraordinary Filipino value is the pakikiramay. This is the value of sticking together no matter what. One for all for one. The strong champions the weak. The able assist the unable. The fast supports the slow. Lastly, we have the value of family. Family sticks around. Family always protects. The family always accepts. These values never change for generations after generations. This made us distinctly Filipinos. No matter how we cope with the demands of the world, these values will determine our hearts, where we come from, and where we start. I may belong to a generation dubbed to be different, more outspoken, more daring, and more competitive. But the things you value are no different from those I hold dear. My family, my friends, my country, my co-creation, and my